We're a charter school approved by the Coweta County Board of Education and the State Board of Education around a particular mission designed to ensure a viable 21st century workforce. How do we do that? We connect the Coweta County School System, West Georgia Technical College, and the local business community in a joint venture. If you follow a timeline of students through CEC, it might look like this. We bring students into an eighth grade charter college and career academy from our six middle schools. Those students continue at CEC while they're in their high school career at our three high schools. They, while in high school, take dual enrollment programs. They're in college programs with West Georgia Technical College while they're in high school. And as they near the end of those programs at CEC, they are interning in local business and industry. We hope the outcome then is that they continue on into additional post-secondary education, or they go into the workplace at higher salaries because they have higher levels of skill, or they do both. And we've got data that suggests that's happening.
I'm Isabel DiGiulio. I'm a junior at CEC. I chose to come to CEC because of the career-based classes. I wanted to further myself in the music programs, and then I took the film program because I needed another elective, and I ended up enjoying it much more than I thought I would, and now it's something that I want to pursue as a career.
In our engineering class here locally, we started a simulation a few years ago with Grinsabout Corporation. The idea was, can we bring pre-engineering students into the workplace, and can we get them involved in real projects at the local company? Certainly we can help them get more training, more education, more application of what they've studied in engineering, but can they produce? And the answer is, we've found out over 3 years they can produce. They can produce for Grinsabout, they can produce for Grinsabout's clients.
I came to the CEC to discuss what is possible, and we had a couple internships already. And it turns out it really develops in a great relationship with these young talents. We actually hired one in the shop already. He started as a welder, his training there with us while he was still in high school. And actually right after graduation we hired him, and he's now an employee of Grinsabout. We have an average age in our shop of 48 years, average tenure 15 years, and I'll have a lot of very good employees retire pretty soon, and I need to replenish this task, you know, force that helps me build all my products.
But I'll tell you what I think is having the biggest impact. Students see the relevance of this education to their future. They see what's important for their career. They see what's important to them in terms of finding their passion. And I think they're motivated by that, and I think they will achieve the level of soft skills that they need to achieve simply because they're extremely motivated and they get the coaching from business and industry and from our great staff here instructing them.
This class is labeled Audio Visual Technology and Film. That's a mouthful. I just tell the kids it's film and television production. It's really hands-on. It's not a journalism class. It's a hands-on, learn the technology, learn how to make film and television. It's working with cameras and tripods and lights and grip equipment, working on sets, doing makeup, all the hands-on stuff that professionals do. It's even some creation, some creativity, where we will create projects, we will come up with an idea, and then we'll bring it to life. I want kids to leave my class being able to go to work, being able to go to work in the industry. So, having worked in the industry for 30 years, I know what I, as a producer, am looking for in a production assistant. We partner with a local cable company. They have a presence here. And by having a presence here, we're able to co-develop programs and work together to meet their needs for their programming needs for the community. So we, meaning CEC and our team members, our students, we're able to get engaged in the local community, providing programming that meets the needs of the community.
5 years ago, NewLink needed a partner to help us with content for our two local origination channels in our cable lineup. And it made perfect sense for us to co-locate our two employees here at CEC, where we can simply walk across the hall and get the assistance from Michael Britt and all of the video production students, whether they're in video production one or two. We've also hired interns and had unpaid interns throughout those 5 years. And it actually allows us to provide better content, more content for our two local channels. But it also gives the students the opportunity to learn and to be creative. And they've actually stepped up and they're now entrepreneurs, and they have a better reason to know what they want to do when they finish school.
My experience at CEC has definitely molded what I want to do career-wise and for the rest of my life, really. Before coming to CEC, I wanted a totally different career, and then it kind of was like an aha moment, and I realized that I wanted to work with music and film, and it's definitely opened a lot of doors for me to be able to go and do that and start at a young age and get jobs and get internships in the workforce and go ahead and further my career.
You know, the magic of what makes a college and career academy work like what we have here is the freedom for me as a professional to create the environment that the students are going to encounter in the real world. And that's important with career academies, that you replicate what's in the field or somehow bring that to the students so it's not something made up. It's not something that's theoretic. It's real world.
You know, I believe in this model because I came from business and industry after studying education at the university level. I believe in this because I had a chance to travel around the world with Bank of America. And I know what our young people today are facing. I know what they're going to face in the future. We have to raise their level of competitiveness. We have to do that very rapidly. We can't wait till they're 27. We have to do it by age 18. I'm really passionate about that. It's a lot of fun to be around this model and to see how we can help bring a community together to focus on the number one asset in our local community. That's our young people.